selector. My birthday recently just passed, and today in this video I'm going to show you how I did my birthday makeup look, which is the look I have on right now. So if you want to know more, then stay tuned and keep watching this video. I will be posting up more videos on my birthday haul and some of the birthday gifts that my friends gave me. And I just want to say a huge thank you to all the friends that have made my birthday so special this year. And if you're wondering why I have this tape over my eye, it's because I just got into an accident during one of my dance classes and I got whacked by a flagpole, right? So you can see how the injury actually looked just about now. Gross, right? Anyway, good thing is I didn't need stitches, I just used surgical glue. Thumbs up for medical advancement, I am terrified of stitches. So yep, I'm really sad because there's probably gonna be a scar over here, but I will let you know again once I can remove the tape. I'm not supposed to be putting any makeup on in that area, so I'm trying very hard to avoid it during all my eye makeup and so on and so forth. So yep, if you want to know more on my birthday look, then stay tuned. I've already put on my BB cream, concealer, eye primer and powder to set. And I filled in my brows as well, so let's start with the eye makeup. I'm taking my Stila Smudgepot in Kitten and applying this champagne cream eyeshadow base all over my eyelids. Using my Sigma E55 shader brush, I'm taking this shade Skimp from the Urban Decay Book of Shadows palette, and I'm patting this on the inner half of my eyelids, going into the inner corners and bottom of my eyes as well. Well, my mama told me don't lose you, 'cause the best luck I had was you, and I know one thing, that I love you. I say hey, I'll be gone today, but I'll be back. I'm taking this color Sin, a light satin pink shade, and gently sweeping this into the outer half of my eyes. With my Coastal Sands round tip brush, taking the color Lost, I'm contouring my eyes by patting this into the outer corners and sweeping it halfway across my crease. Taking the shade Missionary, with my Sigma E40 tapered blending brush, I'm swirling and blending all the colors to soften the look. With my Coastal Sands short shader brush, I'm taking the same shade Lost to line my bottom lids. I'm using eyeshadow instead of eyeliner for that softer and more natural sultry look. I have often walked down the street before. Taking my MAC Blacktrack Fluid Gel Liner with my E65 small angled brush, I'm tight lining my eyes, drawing a really thin line following my natural eye shape. Knowing I'm on the street where you live. To put back some of that shine from all the blending, I'm taking my Stila Smudgepot again and just patting the color on the center of my eyelids for the extra pop. In any other part of town. Now it's time for falsies. Apply a thin layer of glue and remember to wait about 30 seconds for the glue to become putty so it adheres easily onto your eyelids. Oh, the towering feeling, just to know somehow you are near. To cover up any dried glue marks, I'm taking my Lancome Art Liner and going over my lash line.
You may suddenly appear. People stop and stare. They don't bother me. For there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be.
Taking my favorite Nymph Aura Jelly Tint Blusher, I'm rubbing this into the apples of my cheeks and blending it upwards towards my ears. Remember, with cheek tint, you have to blend it immediately so the color doesn't stain your cheeks in patches. Taking my favorite lipstick, this is the Lancome Rouge in Love Pink Shade. I'm applying this all over my lips.
For there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I.
And then I'm layering my Chanel lip gloss in Constellation over for the extra liquid shine.
Can't be here on the street where you live.
And this is the completed look I had for my birthday. It's a soft, sultry pink look. So please subscribe, like, and comment below if you enjoyed this video and want to see more. Thanks for watching!